In my observation, there are very few global corporations who are content with modest profits. The name of the game is always growth. And given Netflix's really inflated stock prices, it's hard to imagine how modest profits are going to be sufficient. There has to be something else at play. Netflix's financial model is still somewhat of a mystery. It relies almost solely on subscription revenue, which is really unheard of in the media industries. It spends more than it takes in, and it has massive amounts of debt. You're paying a relatively small amount, on average around $12 a month, for unlimited access to advertising-free content. That's really never been done before for a standalone company. Probably the closest is HBO, but HBO from the very beginning was always part of a major media conglomerate, so they had a huge set of assets to draw upon to fill out their channel. From the very beginning, what Netflix has defined itself by is its algorithm, all of the data that it collects about everything that we do on Netflix. Every program we watch, everything we start and then stop, everything we put on our watch list and never watch, our choices that we make when we pause, when we rewind, all of these things are part of Netflix's data profile on each viewer. Now, Netflix claims their primary use of this information is to provide better programming options in the future, to drive their acquisition strategy. And certainly they are doing that. However, they have more data and they've invested more in terms of tweaking their interface to ensure, according to one report, that they always want to make sure that you click on your next program within 10 seconds. On Facebook and Google, they're always trying to drive users to the next click. Links that are paid for in some way or another. Netflix, that's not their revenue model. They don't get any more money when I choose to watch the next program in 10 seconds, because no matter what I do, they are still just getting the $14 a month that I pay them. But that data that they're collecting on my tastes, on my viewing preferences, that can be aggregated. That can be brought into a larger set of data-driven marketing techniques. Now, how might this play out? Imagine the reality television programs that Netflix has. If you're watching the Great British Bake Off, you might find that as you surf the web, cooking utensils, advertising, or merchandising follows you. Using Netflix's massive base of viewer data, they might be able to very customized target the products that appear so that there are different versions of shows. So in one given show, a can of Coke might appear, but in another show, it's iced tea. There's no reason to think that Netflix is going to not use that data simply because they haven't yet, or at least they haven't publicly yet. In Silicon Valley, the goal toward maximizing profits always trumps the goal to data privacy and ethics. And because Netflix's business model seems to be questionable in terms of long-term profitability, I think it's time now to stop and ask ourselves, what are they actually doing? And are we okay with that?
Hey, NBC News viewers, thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking on that button down here and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives. Thanks for watching.